Okay, well, I quite like listening to radio, and what I've been using for that is I've been using my TV via an optical out cable to a DAC and my system. My TV's got a screensaver on it, but for some reason it only comes on after an hour, so I began to get worried about screen burn, possibly unnecessarily, but nevertheless. So I went out and bought myself a DAB radio, and I got this one. This cost me £15, so I see it retails for about £100. And this is a Baird TI-400. They're actually seen the same model, but done by Tibo, so I imagine it's a generic model that they bought in. So, if you have a look at the features, it's got an on-off switch, there's a window which shows things like the station you tune to, a tuning dial, there's some presets and you can auto-tune it, there's a DAB FM switch to switch between the two, and around the back you've got an aerial socket and a couple of RCA outs, so you can't use it with an external DAC. So I've been using this for a bit, and a couple of things struck me. Now the first thing, and you probably can't hear this, but there's a slight hum to it, and I don't know if that's a general thing or just specific to this specific item. However, the thing that struck me overall was that FM quality seems okay, but DAB is really quite poor. And I don't think it's the fault of this machine. I was looking at the information window and some of the DAB broadcasts, and these aren't speech channels, these are music channels, are kind of 80 kbps, and you know, in mono. I mean, you know, in 2020, I mean, you know, you can imagine Lord Haw-Haw probably had a better bit rate than that. And you know, don't want this to turn into a bit of a rant, but the quality of the radio coming over the DAB in the UK is pretty poor. And certainly compared to the TV out via a decent DAC, you know, that's, you know, got way better definition and you get better, a more sort of rounded organic quality, it's got better dynamics, you know, it's much better from that. So overall, you know, for £15 for an FM tuner, you know, it's probably okay, but you imagine you could get a Denon used for about the same price, which might be even better. But for DAB, I really can't recommend it, particularly if you're going to spend £100 on the full price model. I mean, it may be okay for listening to the cricket or something, but and speech, but for music, it's I was quite disappointed with it. So overall, I've gone back to the original listening to via the TV. So hope that's been of use to this short video, and maybe see you again soon. Bye bye now.